Hey everybody, how's it going? Welcome back to Rhinestone Island, and what you're seeing right now is a whole bunch of cars being put down in a parking lot, which might not make a whole lot of sense to you. I went and I installed a prop. It's just a whole bunch of props that are all the default car models, and the reason that I did this, I've gotten a lot of requests for doing this at this point, is a lot of these parking lots, especially the ones in the airport, but also the trailhead and the stadium and a few other areas that are kind of parking lot heavy, just don't have any cars parking in their parking lots, and it doesn't make a lot of sense to have an airport parking lot that's totally empty. So I went back, I installed these props, and now we're putting them all in all the different parking lots all around the city. So that's the start for this episode, but it's not the main focus. The main focus of this episode is actually going to be the utility island. So we'll be working on this utility island for the remainder of the episode. You can see I'm just removing everything right now, getting rid of all the default, you know, buildings and all that stuff, what kind of ugly looking sewage pipe, outflow pipes and all that stuff. And well, before we get into the sewage facility, we're gonna first start on the big power complex. I don't know what else you call it. Power complex, I guess. We have a data center in the middle there, which I think just to me, it kind of looks like some sort of large central building that you would have in a big power plant like this. So I thought it'd be kind of cool to throw that one in there in the middle. And then we also wanted to try and focus around having at least one big nuclear power plant, but then also having a few smaller oil-based, or I think in this case, it's diesel or petroleum. I don't remember actually what it's running on, but either way, we have some power plants, we have a couple new assets that I got. You can see it on the far right, and what I'm going to place right now as well. But I did get some pretty cool looking power relay little building and props as well, and they look really cool. I like that, and you can see I'm connecting them to the power lines here, but I just think it looks really nice. I think that these make the whole plant look like one big plant and not a whole bunch of little pieces connected together. So I tried to use these in a couple different places to sort of make it look more realistic, having these power lines just coming out of big power relays instead of coming out of, well, the ground, which looks a bit odd. So that was my solution for that. And then you may have also noticed that we did at one point have a prison on this island, which I got rid of very quickly, so you may not have noticed, but I am planning on going back next episode, and we're going to work on a separate prism that's just off to the side of this existing island that will be its own little island. And it's not going to be like a giant prism, it's just going to be a smaller sort of, I don't know, I like to imagine that this island is pretty well maintained by the police. It doesn't have a whole lot of crime, and so as a result we might just have sort of a smaller prison, not some sort of giant Alcatraz prison or anything like that. So that's the plan for next episode. But anyway, what I decided to do here with this power plant and this whole side of the island in general is I wanted to make this be the very developed side of the island. So we've got these keys that sort of run along the outside. Everything looks very clean and cut. We've got, in the future, we're going to have lots of concrete everywhere, or dirt, and, you know, just lots of supplies lying around and all that stuff. And I'm even going to continue over onto this side with the water treatment plant as well, just being lots of like developed stuff. And then we're going to move away from that and have the other side be a much less developed, more natural looking island. We're going to have a little research center and all that stuff on the other side as well. But for this water treatment plant, I did a little bit of research, not a whole lot, but I wanted to get something that looked at least a little bit realistic to some extent. But these buildings that I got are really, really awesome. So if you want to get these same buildings, you can look in the description below. I've got my mod asset list and all that stuff on Steam linked down below in the description, so you can check that out. And I think it's like probably one of the most recently subscribed items in that list, so it should be at the very bottom. But this whole kit is like it's got like I think two different main buildings that look like just like the main treatment buildings, and then it's also got those giant clarifiers, which are like the giant circular looking things, and then we've also got those huge basins in the middle, which I think are by far the coolest prop that they have, and that looks to me very much so like an actual water treatment plant and sewage treatment plant. So I just went with those for now. It's a pretty big plant, and it's actually a little bit overkill for what we already have. But my plan with this and with the power plant was to try to make something that would not only support our current city, but also support anything else we expand on. So I don't have to go back and add anything else. It should be good for the entire city. Now you may notice something in the bottom there, next to our infinite money symbol. I did actually kick up our taxes quite a bit, and you can see we have an income of like 50,000 right now. So what's going on here is, and I don't know how many of you guys know this, but whenever you enable the unlimited money mod in this game, it doesn't actually stop keeping track of how much money you have. All it does is it just replaces the money with an infinity symbol, and then it allows you to build when you have a negative balance, basically. So if at any point you decide to re-turn on your money, your balance is still there. So just out of curiosity, I decided to turn mine back on again and see where we were in terms of our balance, which I expected to be very negative because I have never touched our taxes. I haven't really at all tried to make our budget be anything beyond, you know, break even. So we're pretty much, you know, going to be really in the red here. And I came to find that we were about $163 million in debt, which for an actual city wouldn't be that ridiculous. But for a city, Skyline City, that's quite a bit of money. So I was just kind of surprised at first that it was so high, but then I just thought, well, what if we kick the taxes up a little bit? What can we get out of this city? Because it's a really big city, maybe not really big for city Skylines. 63,000 is not an insane population or anything, but I decided to like kick up the budget just a little bit and maybe cut back a bit on some of our spending and just see what we could do. And I could very easily get us to 50,000 plus per week or whatever that income value is. And I just let it run for a little while, and I actually managed throughout this episode and the last episode as well to get our balance all the way back to positive. So we're at about, I think, I want to say like 5 million or something now, something like that in our balance. But unfortunately, for whatever reason, and I could not figure this out, I tried a lot of different things, but it seems like the budget has changed somehow since recording this episode. So, you know, far in the future, it seems like the budget just is no longer positive, and I can't seem to get our income to go anything more than like maybe 5,000 a week or something, which is pretty low compared to what we had before. And there really isn't a lot changed since I was recording this. So I'm still working on it, but it seems to me like one of the bigger things that's holding us back is, and this has just been like the case all along, it's very obvious, we have an unreal number of unique buildings in this whole city, just because of all the different skyscrapers and all the different buildings that I placed down. And I really don't put them down with the intent of them being, you know, drawing in tourism or anything. I just put them down because they look cool and they, you know, fit the theme we're going for the city. Because again, it's a lot about the way the city looks and a lot less about, drawing in, you know, tourists and stuff. So as a result, we have just a ridiculous budget for unique buildings, and it's something that's really hard to overcome with the size of the city that we have right now. So what I'm going to do from now on is I'm going to leave it with unlimited money turned on, because I thought when I was recording this that we could very easily maintain this 50,000 weekly budget, but it's really not actually at all reasonable to do that right now. So I'm just going to leave infinite money turned on, but I'm going to keep generating money while we do it, because we're not really losing any money right now. We're generating more than we spend at the moment. So hopefully in the next few episodes, when we start putting down some more residential stuff and we expand the city a little bit, we won't have to put down too many services, because I have all these utilities sort of, you know, figured out already. We've already got plenty of water and water treatment and power and all that stuff and garbage. So we don't really need to spend a lot of money on utilities, and we should be able to balance our budget again, and then hopefully turn unlimited money off and have money again. It really doesn't matter in the end, because I'm not really playing this game with the intention of making a city that makes a lot of money. But I always have been sort of keeping my eye on the budget a little bit, and you guys know I've just been kind of trying to keep it in the green. That's been my goal for this whole series, just because that's a good way to judge if your city is, you know, still profitable and making money, even if it doesn't have a huge balance or whatever. So anyway, that's what's going on right now. I thought I'd just mention it because I was actually planning on just completely turning money, unlimited money, off and having money again, but it seems like we're gonna need to work a bit harder to make sure that works and is solid before we turn it off, because again, I really don't want it to hinder the series at all. I want to make sure we can just be building things whenever we want, because it's no fun to just sit around and wait for money to come in. And it's really not hard to do that either. You can just leave the game on and you'll have a bunch of money in the future, but I'd like to have a good positive income before we do that. So anyway, we're now working on the power plant side again. I just wanted to start doing some detailing around here, throwing down some pipes that sort of run around the extent of this little part close to the key on the edge here. Just some little, I guess, tanks holding some sort of, I think it's like, I was imagining it'd be some sort of fuel or something, because I have a lot of fuel trucks that get parked around this area as we go further into this build. So I tried to do that, but I also tried to put some little office space things over here, little portable offices just around this area. I'd imagine we'd need lots of maintenance, especially in this particular area where the power relay stuff is. So that's what that's all about. I also eventually am going to decide to fence off this whole area and use we're going to fence off pretty much everything surrounding this big power plant. And this is just like all in an effort to make the entire power plant feel like one big like plant and not a bunch of small ones like I've said in the past. So that's what that's all about. Just getting some fencing in here and roping everything off, and then kind of deciding what I wanted to do with this back area over here as well, because again, it is some more of this, like, there's another power relay thing over here, and I thought maybe we should have some more pipes and things, but I think with all these giant buildings it made more sense just to have a nice little back area that's just some grass, and then it becomes, of course, the wild jungle looking island that this is. And you'll see that in a little bit. We're going to definitely have lots of trees and much better foliage than we had before. Because I think before it was just like very, very roughly brushed in default trees. So these should look much better. But using some more of that surface painter tool. And I got to say that again really brings it all together. It's nice to have a consistent dirt texture. It sort of makes everything look like one big unit. So I do like that as well. I tried to use these little traffic cones here to make what I guess would look like a little checkpoint with that little building there as well. I think I would imagine there would be some sort of security right outside of our power plant. I hope there'd be some security, being as it's a nuclear power plant. And I would imagine we need some trained workers and make sure nobody's getting in there that's not supposed to be in there. So that's what that's all about. Now this area, I cut out all the work that I did to make this key work, because for some reason I just could not get this key to draw cleanly. So now that it's working well, you can see I created a little inlet for some water. And the interesting thing about our water and sewage treatment plant is it's a water and sewage treatment plant. So not only are they pumping out sewage, but they're also pumping out water. Or sorry, they're bringing in sewage and they're pumping out water. They're not pumping out sewage. I would hope they're not pumping out sewage. The game calls it pumping out sewage because the default sewage thing is just like a drainage pipe. So I think that like it counts it in units of sewage being pumped out. But in this case, it's being turned into water, or at least that's what they're trying to mimic by having it not only create water but also remove sewage. So with that giant plant there that's doing that, we didn't really need to have that many actual water pumps. So I thought just like one or two would be nice, and that would be enough. But you can see I'm using some of these default rocks now to cover up the island, and then now some trees. And I like the way these rocks look. I think that this whole island would be a lot more rocky, a lot more like a volcanic looking island. I always thought that this mountain in particular looked a lot like a volcano. So I think having some rocks here was kind of a nice idea. It is a pretty steep mountain. You can see that I'm putting trees on pretty steep parts of the island, and the reason being I just wanted to make sure that this whole thing still looked like a big tropical mountain, and just not having trees on it would look kind of odd, I think. So I did get a little bit aggressive with the trees and put them on some of the steeper parts of the island and of the mountain there in particular, but I think it turned out well in the end. I think it was a good idea. But I'm starting, like I always do, with the default trees. So just some of these, the big darker trees and the lighter oaks. And again, I'm going to be doing what I did in the last episode. I'll be using some of the brighter trees that I don't usually use for the more detailed areas, or at least I'll kind of hide the brighter trees and use the nicer custom trees for the edges of the tree line, which I'm going to do with this one as well. But I'm going to throw in some of these brighter looking bamboo trees just to make this whole island look a bit brighter and a bit more like the rest of the island as well. But then of course we're going to go in here with these big oak trees and make all that stuff look nice with the oaks, because the oaks look really awesome, especially on this island. I think it was a nice touch. But you can see the little research center up there, and all of our parking we've got for that as well. And that was all thanks to, again, our surface painter tool. I gotta say, I'm really enjoying making those dirt parking lots with the surface painter tool now. It's gonna be something I'm gonna do quite a bit, especially I think with some of our more like rural stuff on the other side of the island. I wanna have some dirt parking lots and some less than finished looking areas that have dirt around different areas and all that stuff. I think it's a much more common thing that you would find in rural areas, just like dirt parking lots and all that stuff. So we'll use that a bit. But finishing up with the oak trees and moving on to those the shady tree right and shady tree left trees, which are fantastic. And I use those a lot as bushes as well. They kind of look like big bushes that would be sort of surrounding the big rocks up there. And I think once I put down these little picnic tables and make this little key look nice, I'm going to go back with... Actually, I think I forgot. This is what I was doing now, is I forgot to fence off the sewage plant, and then not only fence it off, but I also wanted to make sure we had a couple of those big oaks just to kind of define where our tree clusters were going to be. And then once I had those set out, then I was going to go back and plop down some other tree types and all that stuff. But you can see there that I did have a couple different little trails, and I kind of like the idea of having some trails on this island. I think it's a nice tropical island and would look nice to have some little places to walk for our workers that are working at whatever the power plant or the sewage plant. They could take a little hike, walk up in the mountains, and maybe walk over to the research facility or something, but I don't know, just somewhere to walk I think is nice. But here I'm using this oak just to kind of get in to the further out areas off the mountain. And now that we got it all planned out, you can see I'm gonna reshape the island just a little bit, and then we're gonna jump into the different tree types to start working around this area. Oh, and the rocks, of course. I almost forgot about the rocks. I tried to use quite a bit of rocks actually for this island in particular, because again, I was trying to make it look a lot more rocky and kind of volcanic almost. And so I wanted to make sure the shoreline had plenty of rocks, and even some areas like around this sewage treatment plant, it almost looks like an intentional rock barrier for the edge of this island. So it's kind of like an anti-erosion tool or something like that. Seems pretty common with areas like this, so I thought I would try and mimic that a little bit here. Just some more rocks around this area. We got a little abandoned dock over on that side, and then I even put some rocks on the back side of the island, just like away from everything else, which I usually don't worry about. I don't really worry about putting rocks in areas where they're not really visible from the stuff we're working on, but I don't know, it wasn't that big of an island, so I thought why not. But I gotta say, I like doing these kinds of projects, the ones that I can do all at once. It's kind of nice just to have something to work on and then have a completely finished product when it's all done, you know, just like put a bunch of time into working on this entire island, and then when it's all done, it's all done and the whole thing is completed and looks nice, and you got a big finished product with no unfinished little patches anywhere, which is kind of cool to see. But here we're going in with the shady tree left and right again, just trying to fill out some space, and especially going along the tree lines, you'll see I don't really worry about putting it too high up on the mountain. I'm more worried about getting it in the tree line and just kind of clustering it around these big oaks that are sort of scattered about. And I didn't really do as much of a forest looking thing around the waste management facility. I only did it on the upper part where the mountain kind of comes in, and I wanted to make sure we had some grass space in that area, because I think you wouldn't really have a whole bunch of trees next to the clarifiers. You wouldn't really want to have a bunch of leaves just like falling into the clarifiers most likely. So that's that. But then we're going in with the palm trees here at the end, just to just to get them all around the outer part where the beach is. Make the beach look more tropical and nicer, I think. And yeah, I didn't put them too far up into the trees or anything. I think I kept them mostly close to the edge over here. And then we'll go in now with a few of these shady tree lefts and rights again, and also some bushes and things just to kind of fill out this area. And then we'll eventually get to the grass as well, which of course is my new favorite piece of foliage. Very nice for filling these areas out. Especially nice for making these big open grassy areas look a bit more realistic and a bit less blank and empty and boring. So throwing a few ferns down, just covering, especially trying to make sure we get those beach areas with the palm trees, make sure they have plenty of ferns surrounding them to make it look a bit more green and not so bare and bland. Then moving on, doing a bit of sand over here. I think just tossing some sand in and out of the grass makes it look a bit less bland and a bit more textured as well. And then plopping some of these fallen trees down as well, because I did use them, of course, for the parking barriers again, like I did last time, but I didn't put them down just as decoration yet. So that's what we're doing here. And then filling out some grass on this side. And I don't know, there's something to me about having like that combination of like a natural looking area and then having those like power lines and industry like right next to it. I just kind of like the way that looks. I like how there's like some, and you're going to see when we go back to that little picnic table area again, I'm going to be plopping down some drums of oil or something and other things kind of like overgrown. I just like overgrown industry a lot. I think it looks really cool. So I wanted to get some of that over on this part of the key. On this side, but yeah, here we go. Just some little overgrown stuff lying around, I think. Looks kind of nice, but then we'll finish off with, of course, the fallen leaves and the rocks and all that good stuff. Looks really nice underneath the trees like that. And I think this little area in particular would be a kind of cool place to go and have your lunch if you're working at the power plant or somewhere around this area. You could just hike on over and sit out and watch the ocean and have a good view of pretty much the entire island, actually. You're in a really cool place over here. So that's a nice place for that, I think. I tried to use this grass quite a bit in areas that were close to places I think we'd probably zoom in and want to see up close. And then I didn't use as much, obviously, once you get away from this stuff. So it's not anywhere on the other side of the island, only on this side of the island. I also tossed in some Agula's bigger grass, like wild grass stuff. And that looks kind of nice, just to kind of fade from the wild grass to the smaller grass stuff, and then move into like nothing, and be just like nice clean grass. And I tried to use a lot of this grass around the clarifiers as well, because they don't have anything else really going for them. So I thought some wild grass would be nice, maybe some little bushes here and there and all that stuff. But now we're just about done with the foliage, and we're going to move into the detailing of these little roads and little dirt areas in particular. And again, going with some of the things that I sort of practiced in the last episode with the airport and that little town next to the airport, where I used those big like telephone pole looking things that they're telephone poles and power relays as well, and some little cones and things. So we'll be jumping to that in a minute once I got all these all this wild grass planted down finally, and of course jumping back over to this side and making sure the power station has enough. I try not to put any trees inside this area, just some nice wild grass here and there, for realism's sake. But yeah, just covering the rest of that. There we go. So now we're on to the lighting in this area. And I tried to use some of these bigger lights for the areas like immediately next to the research facility, and then move on to these little telephone poles for the roads, which I really like how these look. I think these telephone poles alongside the dirt roads definitely look like a nice rural looking thing. You'd see that quite a bit in areas like that, so that's a nice little touch, I think. And then I also like doing those big telephone poles that are surrounded by cones. I don't know, something about that looks very I don't know, rural to me. Is something you would do in some dirt parking lot. You want to make sure nobody's running into your telephone pole. And then we'll put down some of these different props, and I tried to detail this waste management facility a little bit at least, have lots of pipes running around, but honestly in the end I think I left most of it just how it is. I think it looks like a very nice looking building regardless of if it has any details in it or not. I tried to fill out these these main buildings though, because for some reason they just have like this huge empty cement area for like no reason. So I did some parking lots in here, and also some little cones, maybe like guiding trucks in and out of these buildings over here. I know that usually, I think what happens with waste management facilities is, and I keep saying waste management, I mean sewage management, obviously, but with these water treatment facilities, it seems like what happens a lot is they have, after the sludge gets removed and they turn it into like a solid, then it becomes like fertilizer or other types of like soil that can be reused, and then they get them shipped out on trucks. So that's kind of what I was envisioning was happening with these little loading bays and all that stuff. And we're back to some more cars, of course, just filling out some of these parking lots with these parked car assets, which again, I think actually ended up looking really nice. And I love how the airport looks now with that giant filled up parking lot. It's a nice little touch, I think, for different parts of the island. And I tried to, for those of you who are wondering, actually, I didn't really address this initially, but you would imagine that just the way that these work, you know, you could have cars that park in the same spot as I've already put down a prop in, and it would have like a duplicate car or something. Well, what I've noticed just from looking at the parking lots is it seems like there's like an order that the cars get parked in the parking lot, and they start on like one side of the parking lot and they move their way down the parking lot. So they're not going to park just randomly anywhere in the parking lot. They're only going to park in the first few spots and then move out from there. And because they don't get a lot of traffic, they really don't get beyond the first like maybe 7 or 8 spots at any given time. So I just leave those empty. That way someone can park in those still. And then I fill out the ones that will never really get parked in anyway. You may have noticed those cones underneath the giant satellite dishes. I wasn't actually a big fan of those, and I think off camera I removed those at a later date, so don't worry about that if you don't like those. I wasn't a huge fan either. I was kind of just playing around with them a little bit and trying to get something that looked nice. But we're moving in now to the final parts of this episode. I just wanted to get some fallen leaves and some rocks and stuff put down, and then some more foliage, and just kind of detail the rest of this area. But you can see that this whole island really came along pretty nicely and wrapped up nicely, I think, as well. And now that we're done with this, I'm really happy to see that we're done with this, because I really didn't like the original looking island. So having a nice utility island that's all finished up and should support the rest of the city is a nice thing to have. And we're moving on next episode, I think, to the prison. So if you have any suggestions for that, leave them down below, obviously. But I'm thinking about, like I said, a smaller prison. We're going to have lots of different prison assets that I already installed, some cool watchtowers and stuff. And just like a small little island prison just off the bank of this island. So anyway, that's it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll leave you with some cinematic shots of the island and the things we did this episode. And then next time we'll come back and work on the prison and get all that stuff wrapped up. So hope you guys enjoyed. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.